Have you ever walked into a room and completely forgotten why you were there? Or maybe you noticed that your memory isn't as sharp as it used to be. You're not alone. These moments happen to all of us, but they can feel more frequent when we're tired, stressed, or just stretched thin. So it's no surprise that many people turn to supplements hoping for that little extra mental edge. But how do you know what actually works? Today, I'm going to walk you through five supplements that have real science behind them for supporting memory, and also share three that may not be worth your time or money. I'm Dr. Tracey Marks, a psychiatrist, and I make mental health education videos to strengthen your mind, fortify your brain, and build resilience. And one way to do that is by understanding how nutrition and supplements impact cognitive health. Let's start with a quick reminder of why memory is important. Memory isn't just about remembering names or where you left your keys. It's essential for learning, focus, and emotional regulation, even decision-making. When your memory functions well, you're more adaptable, more efficient, and better equipped to handle challenges. And while sleep, exercise, and nutrition form the foundation of brain health, the right supplements can provide extra support if you choose wisely. So let's look at the top five supplements for memory support. Number one, omega-3 fatty acids, specifically DHA and EPA. Omega-3 fatty acids and the two types, DHA and EPA, play a major role in brain health. DHA in particular makes up about 30% of the fat content of your brain. It's essential for maintaining flexibility and function of brain cell membranes, which affects how well your neurons communicate with each other. On the other hand, EPA helps regulate inflammation in the brain and something that, when left unchecked, can interfere with memory and focus over time. Multiple studies have shown that people with higher omega-3 levels tend to perform better on memory tasks and experience slower cognitive decline with age. One meta-analysis published in the Journal of Alzheimer's Disease found that omega-3 supplementation significantly improved memory in adults with mild memory complaints. The most effective daily dose appears to be between 1,000 and 2,000 milligrams of a combination of DHA and EPA, with a higher proportion of DHA for the memory support if that's your goal. You can get omega-3s from fatty fish like salmon, sardines, and mackerel, but it's hard to maintain a consistent intake through diet alone, and that's where supplementation can help. If you choose to supplement, quality matters. Look for products that clearly state the exact amount of DHA and EPA and not just say fish oil. Also choose ones that are molecularly distilled to remove contaminants like mercury and chemical residues like PCBs. Also, opt for the triglyceride form over the ethyl ester form. Your body absorbs it more efficiently. Now, if you follow a plant-based diet, you're probably wondering, is there an option for me? And yes, there is. Algae oil supplements are vegan-friendly, and they're a source of DHA and EPA as well. Just know, though, you'll typically need a higher dose of algae oil to match the effectiveness of the fish oil. So it's even more important to check the label for how much DHA and EPA you're actually getting. Number two, citicoline, also called CDP choline. This compound helps your brain produce acetylcholine, a neurotransmitter essential for learning, attention, and short-term memory. But that's not all. It also helps support energy metabolism, which is how your brain generates and uses energy to stay focused, especially during long periods of thinking or problem solving. Citicoline is one of the few supplements that has been used as a prescription medication in Europe and Japan to treat cognitive impairments, including those caused by stroke or age-related decline. But in the US, it's sold as an over-the-counter supplement. Research suggests that citicoline supplementation can improve memory support and overall cognitive performance, particularly in older adults with memory deficits or mild cognitive impairment. Some studies have also shown improvements in attention and recall when it's taken consistently. In terms of dosing, the effective range is typically between 250 and 1,000 milligrams per day. Higher doses have been studied for specific medical conditions, but for general cognitive support, most people fall within that standard range. It's pretty well tolerated and side effects are rare, but some people may experience mild stomach discomfort or a headache when they first start taking it. Number three is vitamin D. Most people think of vitamin D as important for bone health, but it also plays a vital role in brain function. Vitamin D receptors are located throughout the brain, including areas responsible for memory, focus, and mood regulation. Low levels of vitamin D have been linked to poor memory performance, slower processing speed, and even increased risk of cognitive decline in older adults. It also helps regulate key neurotransmitters like dopamine and serotonin, which affect both emotional stability and cognitive clarity. One noteworthy thing, though, about vitamin D is how common the deficiency is. Some studies estimate that up to 40% of Americans don't get enough vitamin D. And if you're among them, supplementation can make a real difference in your cognitive performance. Before jumping into a supplement, it's ideal to get your blood levels tested. If you are deficient, your healthcare provider may recommend higher doses, like 5,000 international units a day or more, to bring your levels up initially. After that, most people maintain with a daily dose between 1,000 and 2,000 international units. When choosing a supplement, go with vitamin D3, not D2. D3 is generally better absorbed and more effective at raising and maintaining your vitamin D levels. And here's one more important tip. Your body needs magnesium to activate vitamin D. Without enough magnesium, you may not fully benefit from your supplement. So if you're supplementing with vitamin D, it's a good idea to make sure your magnesium intake is adequate, either from your diet or from a separate supplement. Number four, the B vitamins, specifically B6, B9, which is folate, and B12. These three B vitamins work together to support brain function and protect against cognitive decline. One of their key roles is helping lower homocysteine levels, which is a compound that, when elevated, can damage blood vessels in the brain and is associated with memory problems and age-related decline. Vitamin D is especially important. Even mild deficiencies can lead to symptoms like forgetfulness, brain fog, or even mood changes. And here's the thing, B vitamin deficiencies become more common as we age, particularly vitamin B12. And that's because B12 needs stomach acid for proper absorption, and stomach acid levels naturally decline in many older adults. Vegetarians and vegans are also at a higher risk of B12 deficiency since it's found primarily in animal products. If you fall into either one of these groups, it's worth paying closer attention to your intake or talking with your doctor about testing. When choosing a supplement, look for the methylated forms, methylfolate for B9 and methylcobalamin for B12. These forms are more bioavailable, meaning your body can absorb and use them more efficiently. And this is especially relevant if you have common genetic variations that affect how you process synthetic forms like folic acid or cyanocobalamin. Number five, magnesium L-threonate. Magnesium plays a role in hundreds of processes in the body, but when it comes to brain health, not all forms are created equal. What makes magnesium L-threonate unique is that it's the only form that's shown to effectively cross the blood-brain barrier. That means it can actually raise magnesium levels inside the brain, and that's where it matters most for memory and cognitive support. This form of magnesium has been shown to enhance neuroplasticity, which is your brain's ability to form new nerve connections. Neuroplasticity is important for learning, adapting to change, and holding on to new information over time. Some studies have also found improvements in working memory and long-term recall in older adults taking magnesium L-threonate consistently. The effective dose is typically between 1,500 and 2,000 milligrams per day, which provides about 144 milligrams of elemental magnesium. That's the actual magnesium that your body uses, since the total capsule weight includes the L-threonate compound. Other forms of magnesium like citrate or glycinate can be helpful for muscle relaxation, sleep, or digestion, but they haven't been shown to significantly increase magnesium levels in the brain. So if your goal is to support memory and mental clarity, magnesium L-threonate is the one to look for. Because magnesium can have a calming effect, many people find it helpful to take the supplement in the evening. It may also support deeper sleep, which plays an important role in memory consolidation. Now let's shift gears for a moment and talk about a few supplements that are either overhyped, under-researched, or just not worth your investment, especially if your goal is to improve your memory. First up is ginkgo biloba. This supplement has been around for decades and was once heavily marketed as a memory booster, especially for older adults. But more recent, large-scale studies have shown inconsistent results. And in healthy adults, without any cognitive decline, the benefits are minimal at best. Additionally, ginkgo can interact with blood thinners and other medications, potentially increasing the risk of bleeding. So when you weigh the limited evidence against the possible side effects, it's clear there are better, safer options for supporting memory. Second is proprietary brain boost blends. You've probably seen these, the ones with long scientific sounding ingredient lists and big claims about mental clarity or sharper focus. The problem is many of these blends don't disclose the exact amount of each ingredient. That makes it impossible to know whether you're actually getting a meaningful dose. A lot of these products use a tactic called fairy dusting, and that's where they include small traces of impressive ingredients like Bacopa monnieri or lion's mane mushroom, just so that they can list them on the label, but the actual dose is far below what research shows is effective. So instead of these mystery blends, look for products that clearly list each ingredient with the exact dose so you can compare it to what's been used in clinical studies. That's how you can separate science from the hype. And then third is high caffeine nootropic stacks. Nootropics are substances that aim to enhance brain function like focus, memory, or mental clarity. But many of these products rely heavily on caffeine to deliver that quick, noticeable boost. These products are often sold as stacks, which just means it's a combination of ingredients designed to work together. In this case, it's usually caffeine plus other stimulants or exotic compounds. While caffeine can temporarily improve alertness, it's not a true memory enhancer. And when it starts to interfere with your sleep, which is often the case, it can actually impair your memory consolidation, which is the process your brain uses to store new information. That big energy spike might feel like it's improved brain performance, but over time, it comes with diminishing returns, like jitteriness or racing heart or poor sleep or common side effects. And ironically, those things worsen memory and focus over time. So if you're looking for a sustainable support for your brain, it's best to skip the stimulant-heavy stacks and focus on nutrients that actually support the structure and long-term function of your brain. So how should you actually approach supplements for memory support? Let's talk about how to take all of this information and apply it in a way that makes sense and gets results. Start with the basics. Before adding any supplements, make sure your foundation is solid. That means having a nutrient-rich diet, physical activity that's regular, and quality sleep, and some kind of stress management practice as well. Supplements work best when they're supporting a healthy lifestyle, not to compensate for an unhealthy one. Then consider testing for deficiencies, and this is especially important for vitamin D and vitamin B12. If you're low in either one, correcting that deficiency can make a big difference in how your brain functions. Your healthcare provider can order those tests and help interpret the results for you so you can know where you stand. You want to add supplements one at a time. If you start multiple things at once, it's hard to know what's actually helping. So give each supplement a few weeks, ideally a full month, before adding something new. That way, you can clearly see what's working and what's not. Another thing you should do is track your results. Rather than going off a vague sense of, I think I feel better, try observing specific changes. And that might mean noticing how often you forget things, or how long it takes for you to find words, or even using simple brain training apps that track focus or memory performance over time. You also want to choose high quality products, Look for supplements that are third-party tested by organizations like USP, NSF, or Consumer Lab. These seals don't guarantee results, but they do tell you that the product contains what it claims it does and is free from contaminants. And finally, be patient. Brain changes take time. Most of the studies showing real benefits from these supplements lasted at least 3 to 6 months, so don't expect dramatic overnight improvements. The goal here is gradual, sustainable support for your cognitive function. In our next video, we're going to zoom out and talk about how food itself changes your brain chemistry. We'll look at which nutrients actually shift your neurotransmitters and how you can know when it's time to supplement. If you found this video helpful, let me know in the comments. Have you tried any of these supplements? And if so, what's been your experience? Make sure you subscribe so that you don't miss the next video. Thanks for watching today. I'll see you next time.